Now, we've obviously heard before about the common debate, Mac or PC, but there's an even older argument between Linux and Windows. I mean, this goes back centuries, and even back when the Egyptians were building the pyramids, they were trying to figure out what operating system to run on them. It was crazy. Anyway, that's what we're going to talk about today. Which is better, Linux or Windows? Because a lot of people, especially a lot of tech enthusiasts who use Linux, swear by it and say that it is better than Windows. And we'll talk about maybe situations where they're right and maybe not always. Now, I don't think this video is going to be for like advanced computer users, because those of you probably can figure out for yourself whether or not you want to use Linux, but this is probably going to be mostly for like an average user who kind of knows their way around Windows. You know, they're not afraid of the command line, because you definitely need to be able to use it at least. So definitely not for people who can barely boot up Windows. And I guess I should point out as a disclaimer, I have used Windows once or twice in the past, so might be a little bit biased. So first we're going to go over the advantages of Linux and then the disadvantages, and then we can talk about some of the overall thoughts. And we can start off with the most obvious advantage, the cost of ownership, and that is that you can get Linux for free. It doesn't cost you anything, unlike Windows, where you gotta pay for a new license if you wanna install it on a new computer you built, or if you wanna upgrade to a new version of Windows, the exception being the most recent update with Windows 10, which they did allow you to upgrade for free, but that is no longer the case. Now, obviously, if this is gonna be for your main computer that you use every day, cost is probably not gonna be the deciding factor, but maybe if you do wanna build a server or something, or just as a fun hobby, then it might be wise to just install Linux on it if it can get the job done instead of paying hundreds of dollars for a license of Windows. Also, another advantage having to do with cost is most of the software, at least the major stuff you'd expect, like word processors and all that, is gonna be free. Most of the software is open source, although that can sort of be a disadvantage that we'll get into later. All right, now next, this is definitely one of the more major advantages that is really easy to understand for most people, and that is that Linux is pretty much inarguably more secure than Windows. And that's for a lot of reasons. First of all, it's open source, it's viewable by a lot of different people who work on it or just are interested in looking at it so they can spot bugs, security flaws, and also there's not as many people who use Linux, so that means it's a much smaller target vector. So if someone is going to make a virus, then it would make a lot more sense to develop it for Windows or even Mac, where there are way more users and a lot less tech-savvy users than it would be for Linux, where generally if you're running Linux software, then you're probably a little bit more advanced, so you know how to lock down your computer, and there's just so few of them that even if you did infect some people, it probably would not be nearly worth your time. That's not to say that there are no viruses for Linux, because there are a lot of non-desktop or user environments for Linux. I mean, there's tons and tons of servers around the world that do run on Linux, but for like a consumer-targeted virus, probably not gonna happen. But that's not to say that Linux isn't actually more inherently secure, because it is. And one of the reasons for that is, unlike Windows, which basically gives all its users admin access, the Linux runs by default in a lower privilege mode. So even if a virus does infect you, it can't really do any damage because it can't access a lot of other parts of the system. And it doesn't require a lot of access to like install programs and all that. So with Windows, typically if you do want to install something, especially for all users, you're going to have to run that as an admin, and a virus would have no problem taking advantage of that. Whereas Linux, it's going to be a lot harder for a virus to even do damage, even if it does infect one of the fewer people it can. All right, so next up, this advantage has to do with ease of installing programs and keeping things up to date. And that is that with Linux, it is a much different system for installing software. They typically use what's called a repository, which means that somewhere on the internet or locally, we're not going to get into that, there is a repository or like a big database or storage center for all sorts of different software that developers will upload their program to. So anytime you want to install software, instead of having to go over to the website of the software, you can typically just go into the command line or the repository GUI that the software has and just find that software and download it. And it will also download anything else required by it. So it's kind of like a big app store. And because this is the way that all the Linux operating systems install software, then that's where everything is available. There's very few where it's not available on a repository that you would have to manually go and download the specific installer file. There are situations like that. And there are multiple repositories that you can set up. So even if it's not available on the main Ubuntu one, you can get it available elsewhere. Now, if it isn't available on a repository or you don't have an internet connection, can be a very big disadvantage, but again, we'll get to that later. All right, now next advantage, this is a pretty big one that you might not have thought of. And this is if you need an operating system, not necessarily for a desktop environment. Maybe you built a computer, like a small box that you want to use as a firewall. Well, obviously it would kind of not make sense to use Windows on a firewall system. It makes a lot more sense to install a server version of Ubuntu, for example. And here's the thing, another advantage of Linux is there's so many different distros, which are called distributions, which are like different flavors of Linux, all with many, many different advantages and purposes. For example, there are some distros which are very specific to running a firewall or something like that. There's also distros for running a NAS, like a backup server or a web server, things like that. So if you do specifically need a purpose-built computer, it's very versatile and there's gonna be a way you can set it up much more specific than just downloading an entire version of Windows server and then only using a little bit of software on it. But even if you do wanna use a desktop environment, there's plenty of different distros for a lot of different purposes. There are some that are good for people who want like the cutting edge of latest updates in technology like Fedora, and then there's others that are very specific for running on like ancient computers that have almost no resources available. Like you only have less than a gigabyte of RAM, like a few hundred megabytes, there's a distro you could download and run that off it. So Linux is definitely a lot more versatile, and even when I say Linux, it's not very specific. If someone says they run Linux, well, you really have to ask, which distro do you use? Because there's so many out there and they're so very different. Another advantage of Linux is kind of tying into the previous one I just talked about, which is customization and themes. So yeah, there's a lot of different distros and they actually do use different themes that may look completely different, but even if you do use a specific distro, you can download other themes. They may look like Windows, you can get some that look like Windows, some that look completely different than anything else you may have used. So you can really get it to look the way you want, whereas on Windows, you can't really do much besides changing the color of the theme and that's about it. All right, now moving on, the next advantage is that Linux is definitely a lot more reliable than Windows. Maybe not a lot more reliable than Mac because it's kind of tied in with the hardware. We're not going to get into that. But Linux is definitely very reliable. Crashes are extremely uncommon. They do happen, obviously. It's not impossible for it to crash, but it's very rare. And also, it's reliable in the sense that you don't really have to restart every time you do anything on it. You know, with Windows, if you don't restart the computer after installing software, sometimes it doesn't behave right, it'll be weird, you can mess things up, potentially, but with Linux, you don't have to do that. You don't have to restart, it just works. All right, now the final advantage that I'm gonna talk about in this video at least is privacy. Linux is definitely a lot better for people who are very privacy conscious because you know with Windows and Microsoft, they are definitely collecting tons of information about you, and I don't even think there's a default way to disable all collection called telemetry in Windows. If you want to do that, you really have to like dig down into the registry and do that. It's kind of crazy. With Linux, it's open source, and there's no like for-profit company behind it trying to collect data on you and all that sort of stuff. Yeah, you might be able to volunteer to send anonymous data, but you can easily disable that, unlike with Windows, where you really can't disable it at all, and they really hide it deep down to the settings. I mean, there's even a setting in Windows I've discussed that like literally gives you a advertising ID that tracks you and then advertises to you. It's really nuts. Now, obviously, this is not a totally exhaustive list of advantages. These are just ones that I think would be like most relevant to the typical user who might be watching this video. And now we can get into the disadvantages though, compared to Windows. Now, the first disadvantage is a major one and possibly the biggest one, and that is compatibility. There's just so much less software available on Linux that is compared to what's available on Windows. I mean, it makes sense because if you're a developer, Obviously, you want more people to download your software. If you're going to focus on one operating system, it's going to be for Windows. It's going to be for Mac. So unless a piece of software is extremely popular and made by like a massive company that can afford to develop on all operating systems, or just a developer who is willing to take the time to develop it for all operating systems, which there are a lot of those, but for the most part, you're really gonna have to get like a free alternative or open source alternative for a lot of software. And a lot of times it's really amateur. It's definitely not as good as the official version you would be used to on Windows. For example, Adobe Creative Suite like Photoshop, Premiere Pro, not available on Linux. I mean, there's software like GIMP, which is a photo editor, but believe me, it's not nearly as good as Photoshop. People say it's as good. It's not, you can't argue it's as good as Photoshop. It's a decent alternative, especially considering it's free, but you gotta be aware that a lot of the software you use on Windows isn't gonna be on Linux. Now, there's alternatives that you can use like Wine, it's a piece of software that basically runs Windows virtually or runs Windows software virtually, but again, it doesn't always work. Another major example is a lot of the biggest video games are not compatible with Linux at all. One exception are some Valve games, which run on Steam, does support Linux to some extent, but a lot of those developers just don't even bother. Now, this next advantage actually kind of ties into one thing I talked about before, which is installing software through repositories. Now, I mentioned if you have a connection to the internet and your software is available on the repository, which most of it is, to be fair, it's very easy to download that software and install it. But if it's not, if you're offline, then installing software is a huge pain in the ass. It really is. There's people who say, oh, it's not that difficult. It kind of is. So normally what you'd have to do, for example, say you want to download a piece of software, you'd have to like put it on a thumb drive and then transfer it over to the computer if you want to keep it offline. You'd have to do that with Windows. But unlike Windows, where you simply run the installer and that installs everything, with Linux, a lot of times there's like dependencies where you have to install some software first before you install the regular package that you're installing mainly. And if you install through a repository, it does that automatically. But it doesn't do that automatically, obviously, if you're just running that package. So you gotta go out and find everything it relies on. You gotta install that first. You have to make sure it's the right version of the dependency. And if it's not, and there's just too many dependencies, you can find yourself in what is affectionately known as dependency hell. I mean, I've never heard of anything related to that on Windows, so just the fact that there's a name for such a thing can kind of give you an example of how much of a pain this is. And I've had to deal with that myself. There's software that, even if it's available on the developer website, the download, I just couldn't get it to install, and it was just not even worth it. I know there's some of you Linux fanboys who are gonna say, oh, well, you're an idiot, you couldn't figure it out. But you know what? I shouldn't have to figure it out. It should just work, and that is a major advantage of Windows. Installing software just works. You don't have to worry about dependencies. It's all in one freaking little executable. So next, the final disadvantage isn't really having to do with Linux itself, but rather the idea of switching to Linux, which is it does kind of have a steep learning curve, especially for someone who has been using Windows all their life, and they're kind of going to be expecting things to work in a certain way. So it might not inherently be a steep learning curve, but just from the fact that people are so used to Windows, it will be an issue for most people. So yes, people say that, well, Linux can do everything that Windows can these days, and that's probably true, but figuring out how to do those things is a totally different story if you're expecting to know how to do it one way and it's completely different. You're still gonna have to look up how to do it. So overall, what would I say is the verdict? And of course, this is just my opinion. There's gonna be people who disagree. And I would say that still, for most average people, doesn't make sense to switch for Linux, mostly because of the compatibility. I mean, if you wanna download some software, a lot of times you just gotta hope it's available for Linux. You can't just assume it's available like you can on Windows. Everything's available on Windows, not the case for Linux. And also, for most people, there's not really an incentive to spend all the time to switch operating systems. For what purpose, really? What are you really getting out of it? I mean, if it can do the same stuff that Windows can do, why not just stay on Windows? Yes, it does allow a lot more fine-tuning for people who are advanced users, But again, that's a very specific case where you would already know that you want to switch. Now, one exception that I would say is if it's someone who really has no idea how to use computers, they're completely incompetent with computers, like, I don't know, like a very elderly relative or someone who doesn't know how to use a computer anyway, then I would definitely say that a Linux operating system is probably the best bet, just because they aren't used to having it one way, so they wouldn't be missing any super popular software, and they are also going to be at a lot less risk at doing something that would result in a malicious infection on the computer because it's just so less risky in general. So if that's the case, then yeah, it's intuitive enough where most people could probably figure it out, especially if they've not used an operating system before and they're not ingrained in it. But other than that, for most people, Windows is probably just fine. I think this video is definitely going to inspire some heated debate, so we can talk about that down in the comments. Obviously, I'm not pretending to be a know-it-all, and this is just my opinion on everything, and you might completely disagree with very valid arguments yourself. Regardless, if you want to keep watching, I'll put some other videos right here. You can just click on those. If you want to subscribe, I make new videos a few times a week, and if you want to click that bell next to the subscribe button to enable notifications, that would be great. Again, I'm looking forward to hearing from you guys, so thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Have a good one.